Hey, how's everybody doing today?
Good.
You're all on summer break now?
Yeah.
That's fun?
Yeah.
How do your parents like you guys being home all the time?
They're sick of it already.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's an honest answer. Well, my name is Brad.
I'm Tyler.
And some of you remember us from last summer. We went on a walk and showed you some fish, and we went down by the river and we did that. Today we're going to switch gears a little bit and we're going to go on a nature hike. So what are some of your favorite things that you like to take along with you on a hike?
Water, snacks.
Okay.
That was good.
Water and snacks.
Binoculars.
Good idea. Is that what you got? Okay. That's a great idea. Anybody else have any ideas? Your imagination? That's a good thing to take along too, right?
Yeah,
that's well, I put together kind of a pack here for what I thought was some important things to take on a hike. I saw some of you guys using some bug spray a little bit ago. That's always a good thing. We're going to touch on why that's important here in a minute. You got sunscreen. If you're going to be outdoors in the sun a lot, you should really have some sunscreen with you. Bottle of water, you mentioned that. Binoculars, you never know what you're going to see a long ways away. This helps to identify that a little better. This is a deer call. You never know when you might need to communicate with the wildlife, so you got to bring along a tool to do that. So we brought a deer call. It also has a compass in it. I whisper to deer a lot. I'm a deer talker. They never communicate back though. So I brought a long sleeve shirt to keep me out of the sun in case it gets hot. Extra pair of socks in case my feet get wet. Some snacks and a flashlight just in case it gets dark on us and we can find our way back home. So that's just kind of some gear that I think is important to take with you on a hike. The other things that are more fun are these guides. A guide for trees of Michigan, wildflowers of Michigan, and some more about trees and types of plants that we might find out there. So the purpose of going on a nature walk is to have fun, right? To see some stuff along the way and try and do some learning. So these books have pictures of different things that we might see out there, and it will help us to identify that. You all know Linda at the library, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So Linda was gracious enough to get one of these guides, and we're going to let maybe one of the older kids take some of these books and guides. And this has some of the animals and birds and butterflies that we might see out there on the trail. So we can keep an eye on. If we see something and we want to identify it, that's when these books come in handy. So who's the oldest here? Probably you two, right? Okay. I'm gonna give each of you some of these pamphlets. That's all about wildflowers. Tell me what this plant right here is. It has three leaves on it.
Poison ivy?
Nope.
Berries?
It's a wild raspberry plant, okay? Can anybody tell me what this right here is that's growing real low to the ground? It's Virginia creeper. Yep, it looks a lot like poison ivy, but it's not. Can anybody tell me what that is growing up the tree right there? That's poison ivy. Okay, so that's three leaves.
That's the big key that you can tell. It's got five leaves. It's normally Virginia creeper and it's okay.
This plant looks almost identical to poison ivy, the leaves. Can anybody tell me what this is? It's more of a tree. More of a tree species?
Poison oak?
Nope, Good guess. This is actually a box elder. So the leaves on a box elder look just like a poison ivy leaf, but that grows upright on branches. Can anybody tell me what kind of tree species this is?
They would have their trees over here. Yeah, what'd you say?
Sycamore. No, it's sycamore. Yep. The way the bark is kind of shedding and yep. Okay. There's a nest. Where? Oh yeah. Can everybody see that nest up there in the tree? I don't think it's built.
I can see it.
It's
right there.
Wow, that's a sycamore leaf. Can anybody tell me what tree this is? What species that is? Right next to the sycamore? I'll give you a hint. It's a wild species of a tree that we like to eat the fruit off of.
Oh.
Yeah?
Cherry?
Wild cherry. That's right. Good guess. What about this tree here? Those leaves are really, really easy to make out with.
Sap tree?
Close, yep. It would be...
They use it for sap.
Yep.
Maple.
It's a maple, yep. So sugar maples are what we make maple syrup out of, right? Okay. It's an oak tree, yep. It's a type of white oak. So we make like hardwood flooring and other furniture out of that type of tree. Right? Yep, they drop acorns, right? Deer love acorns. And actually, deer... Deer's poison ivy, right?
My story's
right. Oh wow, look at that tree.
Like a
possum nest?
Yeah.
Who's going in there to find out?
Me!
Yeah, I don't think you guys.
I wouldn't reach up in there, but.
We'll throw a rock in it.
Wild man.
And there's spiders.
Spiders?
Spiders, because
I'll put a spider web. You see a spider web in there?
Yeah.
Probably an abandoned nest.
Could be.
There's a sap blossom right here. And
a lot of times raccoons like to live in those types of hollow trees, don't they? But can anybody tell me, is this tree alive or dead?
Dead.
It's dead? Okay. There's no poison ivy here, so it's okay. Can you see... Can you make out the, right here, can you see that, what that is?
It's an emerald ash borer.
It's an emerald ash borer, that's very good. It's, this tree was infected with an emerald ash borer, and...
So if you got off some of the bark.
Yep, if you were to take some of the bark off, you'd see all their little grooves in there, and what they do is they, the only living part of the tree is the very outside skin underneath the bark, and what they do is they burrow through that and it cuts the tree off from all of its water and nutrient source and it dies. So ash trees, most of these are now unfortunately dead. They make great firewood and we use them for a lot of different things. It's a hardwood, but a lot of them are dead now.
We won't be using them for firewood very long.
Right, we won't be using them for firewood very long. So you can tell it was an emerald ash borer because there's these small holes in here and they're shaped like a D, like a capital D. And you can see one right there, one right here, one right there. So they burrow into the tree and then they lay their eggs in there and the eggs hatch and those are the larvae is what ends up killing the tree. So it looks a lot like an oak, the bark. Like a white oak, but it's not.
Yeah, look. That's a white oak. What's the air somewhere?
Down trees make really good habitat for nesting birds and raccoons and all kinds of different animals. And once they lay on the ground, fungus and bacteria, they break it down, and they, over time, the tree deteriorates and it releases organic matter and nutrients back into the soil. That's how the cycle of the forest works. It recycles all of its old growth and makes new growth. You see all the underbrush down here? Like that big leaf tree right there? Someday that'll be, if it gets all the nutrients and sunlight that it needs, it'll be as tall as all these other trees in the forest. Kinda. They're kinda like, just like mushrooms. They're type of fungus. So that tree has been dead for a long, long time. And it's trying to deteriorate that tree.
You guys see how it's white and smooth at the top too?
Yeah.
As it keeps growing, that bark just keeps kind of flaking off like that as it goes up.
I would say at least 100 years, maybe 200 years old, wouldn't you?
Oh, I see.
Now you guys see that up there?
Oh, now I can see.
It takes too long to chop it open.
How big do you, how many feet in diameter do you think this tree is?
About like 10 feet.
10 to 20.
About 40 feet.
I'd say 7.
I'd say
30. 7? That's probably a really good guess.
Okay.
I think you're right with approximately 7. Okay. I don't know if it's a good idea to touch one. They're pretty nasty.
There's 6
Look at that.
Oh wow, look at that. Is that like a little dragonfly?
Yeah, some sort of dragonfly species. How bright blue that is.
You see it on the leaf? Oh, it just...
Oh wow.
Look how bright that is. There's blue on your sheet, isn't there?
No.
For colors?
No, it's green, brown, and red.
I see. It's kind of like that. I think it's a type of dragonfly. Mayflies are usually only about that long. And they're really faint colored. That's really pretty iridescent blue.
There's another one.
Yeah, there's another one. Yep. That one's not blue though.
Yeah, he's more green at the head.
They're like magic.
Huh, that's pretty neat.
There's another one that's a whole different color down there now.
Oh yeah. And oil.
Alright. There's the mulberry tree right here. Nope, they're mulberries.
All I found is all.
So you see all the berries growing on that tree?
Oh, I have a tree.
Do you have a tree like that?
Landed.
Whoa.
Kill
No.
Look, I found some. Here, here's a great.
Maybe you can make it across.
It probably is.
Oh, Maddie. Maddie, are you coming?
There's crayfish over here, as you can see the bubbles coming out.
Oh yeah, so those are all the bubbles I saw.
I've seen everything.
There's two people that be there.
Right at the, when we enter the bag, some
water has to be like a
You guys see anything down in the water?
We saw crayfish bubbles.
Water bugs.
Water bugs.
Tadpoles.
I see its feet.
Oh, I
I see a water bug.
Yeah, look how many walk by.
I wish there was there, dude. Look, there's fungi growing on that rock since it's been underwater so long. See this? This fungi? It's kind of soft. There's like a whole bush of it.
Whoa, Mountain Dew.
I'll touch it. Very soft. It's very soft. Just touch it.
Hilarious.
You want to hold it?
Funny,
I feel weird with the person that was falling in.
All right.
Oh, wait, man.
There where the current's going right through the middle of the river and then it comes actually backwards. It's called an eddy. And where all that fast moving water has scoured the bottom out and made a real deep pool right there. There's gotta be some fish down there in that deep spot.
Oh, look at all that.
You guys see all the marks on that tree right there? That's from the emerald ash borer. So what we were talking about earlier, that bark fell off and it exposed all their little trails. That's where that's why the trees die, is because they lose all their connection to the roots, basically. There it fell, into the river, made fish habitat, right?
Whoa, a lily pad!
Dude, you should have a crust. See any turtles?
Yeah, see the turtles out there on that log?
Where?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Who's got the pamphlet?
Wait, guys, there's one.
No.
Oh, there is?
Oh, yeah, look at that.
You can see him with the binoculars? Oh, yeah, there's three of them.
They got way really nice, but.
You saw out here? Okay. Who saw the one on the in the woods, the really pretty green one?
I think
that was a damselfly.
That was there are a lot of damselflies.
Black winged damselfly.
Yeah, there are.
What is this
name? Back and forth there. Oh, you don't
want to see. Catfish. Oh, you had a catfish. It's called me.
Yeah, there's some more over there.
Where is the
what
hole?
Do you think made that hole?
Grandpa.
I don't know.
Grandpa or a bunny?
A bunny.
Thank you very much.
No problem. Yep. We'll have to do it again sometime.